Good morning, gentlemen. The grace of God be with you all. Unfortunately, our crane number one and number three encountered a breakdown. That is, the reduction gear for hoisting was broken. The gear was broken due to the rough operation. The other ships of our company also encountered the same. But they're suspect that the reason why what is being done is that the reduction gear was broken from this reduction gear. Because this one, they say that the spring of this brake, hydraulic brake, was not fully open. That's why the spring also become the load. This is a hydraulic brake. This is the brake van connected to hoisting drum. This is a gearbox. We encountered two pieces broken gearbox. The driving gear here, this one is broken. Then my friend, that is not the hoisting drum gearbox. That is the looping drum gearbox. You see, this is the brake van is small. It looks like this because it was already sent to shore in Singapore, but there's in a picture they're almost the same, but the only difference is the size. The hoisting is much, the gearbox of hoisting is much larger than this. The hoisting the looping gearbox is not a no problem, not broken, but since the gearbox cannot during the overhauling, since the gearbox cannot pull the remove from its location in the crane, in the cargo D crane number 3, looping unit, the hoisting the looping, because the location is the upper side of in the structure, later on we will go up there. But for pre-advance of our topic, how this was being dismantled, this is the unusual happening, unusual breakdown. For the past 20 years, this is the first time I encountered that the gearbox was dismantled. I encountered many kinds of trouble at the time of the crane, but for the past 20 years, this gearbox, first time I ever experienced that this was being overhauled. First time experience that it was broken. And anyway, that happens once in a lifetime. But maybe it will happen also to you, so just take note. The hoisting drum, the hoist was located on the downside, and the upper side is the looping drum. Then, same as with the gearbox for hoisting, it is on the lower side because it is coupled with the drum, and also that way, and also the gearbox on the upper side, the looping side, is coupled with a looping drum. For example, this is what we call the drum. This is the looping drum. The function of the looping drum is to up and down of the boom. The boom. That's why they call this looping. Sometimes this looping, they call this the jib up, jib down. But this is the driving gear, driving by this gearbox. This is the gearbox motor, and there is a hydraulic motor also coupled here. Then the piping here in and out. Yeah. Can drive the gear here. In it, you see, even this is not a electric motor, this is also a motor because it is moving, it was rotating. But the only difference with electric, it was driven by hydraulic, then driving this gearbox. And this one is for a little. Share with you, sharing knowledge. This is the hydraulic fan. This fan is used for the cooling system of the hydraulic oil system. This used for the cooling down of the high temperature of the oil for the system. From here, this is the oil cooler. This oil cooler. From here, the oil is passed through here. Pass through. This is supposing this is a inlet, and this is because there are only two entrance. One is the inlet, and the other one is the outlet. Hydraulic oil comes from here. Then to make it this is the hydraulic oil cooler. Once the oil passes here, before it comes out, the high temperature was being reduced using that hydraulic oil fan blower. And this one is an electric motor. This electric motor is driving the hydraulic pump. Main pump, hydraulic pump. If you want to see, this is the hydraulic motor. Yes! I told you that this electric motor was driving the hydraulic pump. There's a pump here, but it was left there on top of the crane. The chain coupling. This is a coupling. They are using a chain coupled with a pump. Since the damage was only the twisting here, it was yet to cure. So the remaining here is just the looping gearbox with a looping drum for crane number one, because the breakdown comes from crane number one and crane number three. So that's it. Okay, have a nice day. This is what they call the pinion gear with a bearing, self bearing, and a roller bearing. This one you can. This comes from the twisting gearbox. Comes from here. What's being removed? This is the looping gearbox. From cargo crane. Crane number one, big crane number one. This is the twisting gearbox. The pinion gear here, there is a pinion gear here. This is the shafting. This is the gearbox. This is the hydraulic motor. This is our looping drum. Yes. It was being hung because nothing to use. Yes. No, not included in the repair because everything is okay for the lapping drum. This is the base frame for the starboard side, and the base also here also have a port side, and for other units already taken down. So then you see this one is a block for the controller for the like a manifold. This is a sleeving controller, looping controller, and this is the hoisting controller. Then connected with that hose, this cable connector going to the cabin connect. Where the cabin operator was used manipulating. This is our sleeving pump motor driving the sleeving machinery, sleeving bearing. Later on, I will show you where the sleeving bearing. But this is the driving gear, the driving machinery, the driving machinery for the sleeving motion. Sleeving operation from left to right. This is the sleeving hydraulic motor, not electric motor, because it was being operated by hydraulic. This is the in and this is the out. The oil comes here, is the one operating, rotating this hydraulic motor. This is not electric motor, this is hydraulic motor driving the sleeving pump. We have also a hydraulic brake. The brake pump, the sleeving ring, that like that. And also you can see here, it was already dismantled at the back of this lobbying and wasting ground. There is a ruler used for slack safety purposes. Once the cable is not operating properly by the operator, it will stop by means of the slack limit switch. One for the wasting limit switch for slack, and the other is for looping. The sleeving bearing. This sleeving here is the driving bearing, driving gear from the driving driven by the gearbox also. Sleeving gearbox. Then the other driving, the one driving the gearbox for the sleeving is the sleeving hydraulic motor. This is, you see this gear, this is the one pushing this big crane to go to the left and go to the right. We call this sleeving to the left, sleeving to the right. This is the one rotating the, this is the one causes the sleeving to the right and sleeving, the movement of this big crane. You see this? This is the hydraulic pump, hydraulic motor. The hydraulic pump or the main pump was in the back of operator's cabin. It was already secured. This you see is only a piping, hydraulic piping. This is the brake band. The smaller one is the looping drum, looping band. Brake band, and this one, the bigger, is the wasting band, and driving by looping brake, hydraulic brake, and this is the hydraulic motor for the, I think this is looping. This one is the slip ring unit. This slip ring unit have a carbon brush inside. Three-phase power supply for the electric motor. For this big ring, inside is the no three carbon brush, special carbon brush. Four, because there is a neutral wire. You see this one. This is supplying here, go to the panel board. This where it was, this rotating 360 degrees also. And that's it.